Hi, welcome to the Readout. We are joined today by our Assistant Secretary for Economic and Business Affairs, Manisha Singh, who has been on the job here at the State Department for 4 months now. We're finally getting you down here to talk to us.
It's great to be here.
For the Readout, and a thrill to have you on board. We're really happy to have your expertise here at the State Department. So you've been very busy. It's hard to catch up with you because you're always traveling. You've been working on open skies. You've been working on taxes, tariffs, issues. I'd love to hear about some of your policy goals for your bureau for 2018.
Absolutely. Well, Heather, it's a pleasure to be here today and talk about economic measures in the State Department. As you know, the President's new national security strategy outlines that economic security is national security. One of my key goals for the Bureau is to make sure that we fit economic policy priorities squarely within foreign policy. Part of that is better connecting the State Department and what we do for America to the American people. For instance, I think a lot of people don't know that the Economic Bureau specifically helps companies who want to export. If you are a company in the heartland and you want to figure out how to access global markets, the State Department can help you. We have a network of over 1,500 economic officers all over the world, and they are ready to make the connections for you in the host country governments where you want to do business. Part of that also through our trade programs is to make sure that there's a fair and level playing field so that you don't encounter barriers to entry when you're trying to access a global market. So we're here to help.
Will you help advise companies if a company is interested in getting into country X, but there are certain things that might prevent them from doing that, or if a company doesn't want to run afoul of Office of Foreign Assets Control out of the Treasury issues, will you advise them as well?
That's exactly what we do. If you go to a particular country and you think, well, how do I set up here? How do I navigate the complex regulatory landscape of this foreign country so that I can successfully do business here? That's exactly what we do. You know, and as I mentioned, we have economic officers posted in every embassy, every consulate around the world. They know the host country. They know the government. They will meet with you. They will talk to you. Our ambassadors are fully engaged in helping American companies abroad.
Oh, that's so interesting. Okay, well, one thing that we've heard a lot about in recent weeks have been our China 301 tariffs,
yes.
Also Section 232 involving aluminum and steel. Your bureau is involved in some of those. Talk to us about some of the president's priorities when it comes to overall tariffs and trade.
We are. And, you know, as I mentioned, Heather, this president has come into office saying one of his key goals is to level the global playing field so that American companies can compete fairly. We have a rules-based trading system. And when countries take advantage of these rules to game them to their advantage or work in a market that's unfair, we want to solve those problems for American companies. We want to make sure that the rules are level and fair for everyone. And the Section 301 initiative, the Section 232 initiatives, which are specifically aimed at steel and aluminum overcapacity, are all aimed at that. We want a rules-based trading system that's fair for everyone, especially our American companies.
You certainly jumped into a busy bureau
I did.
At the State Department. You are the first woman assistant secretary in your bureau. What is that like? How does that feel? It's interesting.
Well, I'm so pleased. I'm so pleased and honored to be leading this bureau. And I can tell you, we have a conference room in the Economic Bureau in which hang the photos of all the prior assistant secretaries. Some of them are black and white. Some of them are in color. But as you noticed, all of them are men. And the young women in the Bureau encouraged me to hurry up and get my photo on the wall because I am the first woman. So I'm very pleased and proud of that because I'm hoping that other young women will see me and think, well, there's nothing that we can't do. There's nothing that women can't do.
Yeah, and you're certainly in a big job. It's a Senate-confirmed position.
Senate-confirmed position.
Sure your family is very proud of you. What was your reaction when you told your family about your nomination and then your confirmation?
Well, my parents were very proud. My family, we immigrated from India. I was actually born in India and I came here at an early age. And my parents just knew that this was a country where a young girl can grow up to be anything she wants to be. And I think that they're very happy that I took full advantage of everything that this country has to offer. And public service is also my way of giving back to a country that has given so much to my family.
That's a great story to hear, especially having been an immigrant family. family. So tell me about some of your personal priorities, because women's empowerment and giving women economic incentives to start their own businesses is something that's a priority of yours. Explain what you're doing.
Absolutely. One of the things that we would really like to do is help women build the networks they need to succeed. There are so many women out there. Let's take the technology industry, for instance. If you have an idea for a technology company, well, what you need is the network to build that company. You need access to financing, access to markets, access to understandings of how to grow and develop your business. We want to make sure that women have the same access to those skills and tools they need to succeed. So part of our goal is to create forums, to create mentorships, to create ideas that help women succeed in every area that they want to. And that also ties into my initiative of connecting the State Department better to the American people. We want the American people to understand that we really are here to help your business succeed, in particular women and also small and medium-sized enterprises. I think we know that multinational corporations have an access to a variety of resources to help them. But I've had some small and medium-sized companies, SMEs, come in and say, you know, we don't have a government relations presence. And so I've told them, our door, the Economic and Business Affairs Bureau, is open to you.
So how can you help a small company that perhaps wants to do more business overseas?
Well, that's exactly as you were saying about helping navigate the regulatory landscape. You know, they may not have this broad network of consultants and lobbyists. We have economic officers who can sit down with an SME and say, okay, you want to do business in this market. Here's how you start. Here's the barriers that you might encounter, even setting up. Do I need a joint venture? Do I need to partner with a local industry to be able to succeed here?
And you're setting up a task force surrounding this. Tell me about that.
Well, we would like to have, you know, I have right now an existing advisory committee on international economic policy. So we're trying to further develop that, maybe develop a women's economic empowerment subcommittee to provide that exact sort of advice.
Okay. And I imagine you spend quite a bit of time talking with members of Congress. What do you hear from them in terms of their priorities and what they would like to see from the State Department as it pertains to economic and business affairs?
I think members of Congress, it ties directly into this president's agenda of leveling the playing field for American companies. You know, every member of Congress, whether in their state or district, has industries that they are trying to promote and represent. We want to bring foreign direct investment to the U.S. that creates greenfield investment or creates jobs, job-creating investment. Every member of Congress wants to work with us to create economic growth and prosperity in their home markets.
Also an area that you're interested in is young women.
Yes.
And empowering young women and getting them to think about careers in business. What kind of work are you doing on that?
That's another area where I think mentorship is great. I recently spoke at a Chamber of Commerce event on International Women's Day. So we were trying to make sure that young women and girls know that they can succeed in every field. And part of that is in STEM education. You know, that we have a shortage of women in science, technology, mm-hmm. in the math fields. So we're trying to get women who have been leaders in the technology field to encourage these younger women to maybe major in math, something that they haven't thought about.
And does that also involve bringing young women over to the United States from other countries? Are you working with Consular Affairs to do any of that, to help young women from all over the world go to STEM camps and things of the sort?
Absolutely. We have an international visitors program where we do exactly that. And one of the ideas is maybe to bring American women to foreign countries or women from other countries here so that they can learn and partner from each other. You know, we want to build a girls' network around the world so that everyone can share in the benefits of economic prosperity.
Okay, that sounds like a great program that you have. We're so happy to have you on board, and especially all businesses are important, but helping women and helping young women in particular is key. So
it is important, and Heather, we would love to have you as a speaker. I consider you to be a role model. I know you've assumed a new position here as the Acting Undersecretary for Public Affairs, and so I think a lot of young women in the building are looking up to you as one of the women leaders and role models in the building.
Oh. Whatever you need. Happy to do it. Manisha Singh, welcome on board. Come on back and tell us more about some of these initiatives.
Thank you, Heather.
Okay, thanks so much. And thanks, everybody, for watching.